6 now, temporary freedom for Navy SEAL Edward Gallagher. Many, many eyes are watching the case of this warrior who is accused of murdering an Islamic State terrorist. Imagine that. He's in trouble for killing our enemy. Gallagher had spent many months in the brig until now, so for now, he's free to fight. So here's the issue. We want to support this guy, of course. Who cares about the life of that cutthroat in a headscarf who wanted to slaughter all of us? On the other hand, the military has rules and we have laws that cannot be broken, right? Joining me now, the founder of the American Truth Project and Daily Ledger contributor, Barry Nussbaum. Barry, he deserves, Gallagher deserves his day in court, and he also deserves not to be treated like a criminal for simply doing his job.
It's so difficult for us to armchair quarterback this, Graham. Can you imagine the pressure these operators are under, where the Iraqi civilian that smiles at you 5 minutes later might be planting an IUD under your Jeep or poisoning the water you're drinking? And there's an enemy literally around every corner. So it's very difficult to figure out without knowing the witnesses and actually conducting pre-trial investigations, whether there's guilt or innocence of violating the military code of conduct. Having said that, these men and women that face peril and death every day in defense of our country deserve respect and deserve to be treated properly and deserve to be considered innocent until proven otherwise.
Yeah, one of these days we're going to hear the whole story, Barry. And I believe it probably involves some bureaucrats that perhaps were not appointed by this president and possibly the previous president. And I think this whole thing's going to come out and come together, and we'll get the entire story. And I think in the end, this guy's going to be exonerated. Now, this gentleman by the name of Thomas Hoffeller, nobody knows who he was. He died, and he was a political consultant for primarily Republicans. And he was involved in the census and asking the question about whether you're a United States citizen or not. And so somehow the New York Times gets their grimy, grubby fingerprints all over his hard drives. And on the hard drives, he talks about how it can benefit the Republican Party. And I say, yeah, so what? It could benefit in California and New York to actually have a headcount of United States citizens.
Well, there's a couple comments I have on this. First of all, the headline was so biased. It's almost like from Mad Magazine, the shady plan of the GOP. This ran on a major news network. In other words, you read the headline and you already know they hate Republicans and they feel bad for Democrats. That's number one. Number two, the census and gerrymandering related to the census has been going on since 1790. So it's not something new. It's prescribed in the 14th Amendment. The problem I have with this whole argument, Graham, is all Trump wanted to do was to say, we're going to count citizens. As if that's something controversial. Oh my goodness, we're counting citizens to decide who gets what vote for what representative in the Congress. And Dems are going crazy because they want to count all the tens of hundreds of thousands of illegals that are here as if they should be voting. It's offensive to every American, or at least, Graham, it should be.
Yeah. And you know what? We deserve to know how many illegals are in our country. And if they're afraid to answer the question, these illegals, and they run away and they self-deport, well, there you go. Two birds with one stone. Now, speaking of crazy Democrats, in California, I had to read this headline a couple of times and the story a little bit. I'm going to read the headline and you can talk about it. California Dems propose resolution linking Israel to massacre at Pittsburgh synagogue. Can you explain this one to me?
Well, no, until you go behind the scenes and figure out where it came from. The co-author of this Democratic resolution that's going to be debated in the Democratic Party convention, which, by the way, most of the major Democratic candidates for president are going to be there in support of this. The guy that co-wrote it, listen to some of his quotes. Chuck Schumer is a schmuck. Chuck Schumer is a traitor, and he's a member of the fascist Israeli lobby. Those are quotes from the guy that co-wrote this, who runs the Arab American Caucus and he is going to present his resolution in support of dismissing Israel as a fascist apartheid state, along with, get this, the minority leader in the Senate. It's gotten so crazy in the Democratic Party that if you want to support an American ally, in fact, the most important American ally in that part of the world, you're a racist, you're a schmuck, you're a fascist, and every other name you can think of. This is right out of the Joseph Goebbels schools of propaganda. Tell a lie big enough, often enough, and eventually people start to believe it. This is nuts. It's Mad Magazine taking over the Democratic Party. Honest to goodness, I've never, ever seen anything this outrageous.
The only thing that was accurate in his statement that you read there was that Chuck Schumer is a schmuck, because Chuck Schumer is a schmuck. but it's more proof that the Democrat Party is the party of anti-Semitism. It's incredible this is going on. Barry, thank you.